So ladies and gentlemen, if you could now please all stand and join us as we wait to greet our bridal party. Gentlemen, please do take your seats. Well, good afternoon, everyone, and welcome to this celebration of marriage here at Carbis Bay with a very special welcome to our beautiful bride, our dapper groom, and I think I'm just about to run out of tissues, I think. So it's a very warm welcome to you all, and of course, ladies and gentlemen, it's a very warm welcome to you all here at Carbis Bay. Please allow me to introduce my dear friend and colleague, Lydia Forrester. Lydia is the registrar for marriages for this district, and she will record the details of today's ceremony in the marriage register, where there will be a record for all time of your marriage here today. My name is Mark Teasdale, and it is my great pleasure to officiate for you here today on what I hope you will all enjoy, a Cornish wedding, a proper Celtic red thread running throughout today. When I spoke to these guys on the phone, they wanted a wedding with a bit of a view. Well, I think we've got that today, and the dolphins will be here at 1:45 when you're offering confetti. I must now begin this ceremony by telling you all that this place in which we are now met has been duly sanctioned according to law for the celebration of marriage. And wow, what a powerful opening paragraph. Lydia and I will see the legal requirements today. That you are all here to celebrate the marriage of George and Beth, and for you, their witnesses, to hear their vows of matrimony here today. I know it means a great deal to them that you can all be here today. Through their vows, they are making a commitment to each other for the rest of their lives. Marriage is not an easy path. It requires devotion, the ability to listen, the wisdom to know when we are wrong, slight stage look at George, and the strength to put those things right. Of course, for honesty, patience, and of course, humour. And you haven't, but it's been my pleasure to hear so much fun and laughter in this room already today. It also requires closeness and distance. The closeness of a couple growing together with just enough distance to allow you to be your own unique and individual selves. For George and Beth, getting married today is a proud confirmation of the love, the respect, and the true friendship that you so clearly have for each other. Together you will be stronger to meet whatever life may hold for you. And today, you will exchange vows which will unite you as husband and wife. And those words before your family and friends are a public pledge of your love. But may I start with our groom, sir, and ask you for your full names, please?
George Patrick Kane.
Thank you. And for you, ma'am, may I have your full names, please?
Bethany Elaine Egan.
If any person here present knows of any lawful impediment to this marriage, they must declare it now. Silence is golden. I've got the nod from Lydia. We're good to go. But a very important question for a very clearly proud father, Julian, today. And I hope, sir, you will respond, I do, to this question. And who gives the hand of Beth in marriage to George this day?
I do.
Thank you, sir. Gentlemen, thank you very much indeed. Please do take your seats. Just hold hands there. Face the beautiful view. That's lovely. Before you are joined in matrimony, I am required by law to remind you of the solemn and binding character of the vows you're about to make. Marriage, according to the union, the law of this country, is the union of two people, voluntarily entered into for life and to the exclusion of all others. So much more than this. Marriage is a relationship based on love and trust, encouragement and support, and the sharing of that joy and laughter I mentioned earlier. Now I'm going to ask each of you in turn to make the legal declaration that you know of no lawful reason why you may not be married to each other. And I'll start with you again, George, if I may, and I hope you're legally able to respond, I am, to this question, sir. Are you, George Patrick Cade, free lawfully to marry Bethany Elaine Egan?
I am.
I hope you are legally able to respond, I am. Are you, Bethany Elaine Egan, free lawfully to marry George Patrick Cade?
I am.
Now the solemn moment has come for these two persons to contract their marriage before you, their family, friends and witnesses before Lydia and myself. And the exchange of marriage vows in the presence of family and witnesses forms part of a long tradition of marriage in this country. George and Beth, you invited all these good people to be here with you today. You invited them here to receive their encouragement and support. And I suspect to hear you answer the I do question. And I'll start with you again, George, if I may, sir. So I hope you are able to reply I do at the end of this question. And so I must ask you now, George, do you take Beth to be your wife, to comfort her in life's sorrow and pain, to rejoice with her through the good times, and to remain true to her for the rest of your lives together?
I do.
Beth, I hope you respond with such alacrity. And so I must ask you now, Beth, do you take George to be your husband, to comfort him in life's sorrow and pain, to rejoice with him through the good times, and to remain true to him for the rest of your lives together?
I do.
Thank you, Beth. George and Beth, you are about to make the most trusting and absolute commitment that any one person can make to another. You are about to put your love, your life, and your future happiness into each other's keeping. Ladies and gentlemen, we're just about to enter the more solemn part of the ceremony, so if you're free and able, could you please stand and join us? I'll ask the couple to face each other and look at very much indeed. So, George, would you please repeat after me that you're saying these words very much to death? I, George Patrick Kay.
I, George Patrick Kay.
Take you, Bethany Elaine Egan.
Take you, Bethany Elaine Egan.
To be my wedded wife.
To be my wedded wife.
Now, Beth, would you please repeat after me? I, Bethany Elaine Egan.
I, Bethany Elaine Egan.
Take you, George Patrick Kay.
Take you, George Patrick Kay.
To be my wedded husband.
To be my wedded husband.
Thank you very much indeed. Ladies and gentlemen, please do sit down apart from our men. The wedding ring is the ancient and traditional way of sealing the contract that you have both just made. As we shall see in a second, your rings are unbroken circles, and they symbolise an ending and everlasting love, and they are the outward signs of the lifelong promises you have just made to each other. So Matt, would you now please step forward first, please, sir?
Yep.
Open your box and kindly offer, yeah, that's great. And kindly offer Beth's ring to George. Thank you. So now, George, would you place Beth's ring on the third finger of the left hand? Just hold it there for me, sir, and kindly repeat this vow. But again, say it very much to Beth. Beth, I give you this ring.
Beth, I give you this ring.
As a token of the love we share.
As a token of the love we share.
And the vows we have made today.
And the vows we have made today.
I slide that ring all the way up. So Richard, would you now step forward, please, sir? And this time offer George's ring to Beth. Thank you, gentlemen. Please take your seats. You're very kind. So Beth, would you kindly please place George's ring on the third finger of his left hand, around about the knuckle mark. Just hold it there and kindly repeat this vow after me. George, bring your right hand up to kind of sit out. Perfect. George, I give you this ring.
George, I give you this ring.
To join us together.
To join us together.
Wear it with happiness and pride.
Wear it with happiness and pride.
Now and forever.
Now and forever.
And slide that ring all the way home for me. As well. Please continue to hold hands facing each other. Ladies and gentlemen, you may well have heard it, the phrase to tie the knot. George might go back to work next week and say to his colleagues, oh yes, Beth and I tied the knot at Carbis Bay last Saturday. History tells us this is a very Celtic tradition, dating back to maybe 1700s and 1800s still practiced. And in those days, a village elder like myself would literally tie a piece of rope around the couple's wrists. And with every word that were spoken, he would tighten that knot. That's where the phrase to tie the knot comes from. And we're going to enjoy that today, but I'm sure you'll all be pleased to hear I don't have some rope that was in St. Ives Harbour around a lobster pot yesterday. But I am going to offer the same words that would have been spoken, albeit in modern English, 200, 300 years ago. And what I want you to do is as I say each line, I want you to imagine that I'm tightening that knot, tightening your bond tighter and tighter around your hands. But these are the hands of your best friend, strong and full of love for you. For these are the hands that will work alongside yours as together you build your future. For these are the hands that will hold you when fear fills your mind. For these are the hands that will wipe the tears from your eyes, tears of sorrow and tears of joy. For these are the hands that even when wrinkled and aged will still reach for yours. For as your hands are bound together now, so your lives are joined in a union of love and trust. The bond of marriage is not formed by these cords, but rather by the vows you have made from your heart this day. Thank you very much indeed. And I'll now invite Maxie to step forward, if you would please, Mum, and offer us a reading. Please relax. Consider the room untightened.
They say that sometimes love starts with a spark, and that might be true, but if I were to wish you a love, I wouldn't wish fire for you. You see, fire is powerful, it burns bright and then it's gone. It's beautiful and warm, but it doesn't last long. So instead of wishing you a love that burns, I wish you a love like a river that twists and turns. It changes and it flows, it's powerful and free, but it consistently finds its way back to the sea. And so like the water, I hope your love is ever growing, ever changing. I hope your love is powerful and free, and may you always find each other like a river finds
itself. George and Beth, you have both made the declaration prescribed by law, and you have made solemn and binding contracts with each other in the presence of your witnesses, family and friends, before Lydia and me. You have further given and received those beautiful rings as tokens of your love and commitment to each other, and you have now been bound together for all time as you tied the knot with your vows. Today is a very special day for you both. May the happiness you have found be yours through a love and lifetime of friendship. And will those of you who witnessed today's ceremony please continue to support George and Beth in their future life together, because it is my very great pleasure to announce that by the powers vested in me, but so much more importantly, by the beautiful vows they've just said to each other and the rings that they have exchanged, you are now husband and wife, and George, you may kiss your bride! May peace guard the door of your house and the door of your heart. May the road rise up to meet you and the sun stand at your shoulder. May the rain fall softly and the wind always be at your back. May life itself be your friend. Each day, each night, each step of your journey from this day on. Ladies and gentlemen, let's all put our hands together for the new Mr. and Mrs. K.